This video uses the fx-300ESPlus2 second edition scientific calculator to show you how to use the calculator to calculate a mean and a median. This calculator will not calculate mode, so that is something you'll have to find visually. Obviously, you could also calculate mean and median simply by adding up, dividing by what you have, but I'm showing you how to use the actual calculator calculations, the auto calculations. First thing we need to do is enter our data. So we're going to go into mode and choose statistics because you want to enter it as a list. So when I hit 2, it asks you for a couple choices, and we're interested in the one variable statistics. So we choose number 1. It brings us a list, and now we enter our data. And to enter data, it's very easy. You simply type in the values using the keyboard, hit equal to set it. It moves you to the next row. And then when you're done, you don't need to start entering anymore. Now, to do calculations, I want to let the calculator know that I'm done. So I'm going to hit all clear first. And then I'm going to, and so notice that brings me back to this main menu. And then I'm going to go into the stat menu again. But notice it's above the 1. So down here over the 1, you'll see the word stat. It's in yellow. So that means hit that first shift stat. And now, depending on what I've entered, so in this case, I've entered one list. So it's giving me my options for one list. We've already picked the type, that was the one variable. We've already entered our data, so now we can do some different things. Now, we're interested right now in central tendency, so the sum is not appropriate for what I need. Or it might be. I could, if I hit 3, it's going to say, do you want the sum of the input squared or the sum of x? And maybe I am doing this by hand. I could hit 2, and it will give me the sum of these 5 values, and now I could divide by 5 and find the mean that way. So that's one way to do it. Let's go back into Shift 1, our stat menu. Let's go into 4. 4 is where we're going to find the mean. So let's hit 4. So you'll see what I get here. I can get my n, the number of data. Well, that's pretty easy for what we have, 5. But here's where my mean exists. So I'm going to hit 2. Notice you could also do standard deviation for the sample and standard deviation for the population. That's what 3 and 4 are. So let's hit 2. And again, notice it's not found the mean yet until you hit equals. It's telling you that it's going to find the mean. And when you hit equals, that sets it. So the mean of this set of data is 225. How would I then find the median? So let's again do Shift 1 to get back to my stat options. And median is going to be in number 5. Number 5 is you could find the minimum x, you could find the max x, you can find the quartiles, but then we also have the median here, which we're interested in. So we're going to hit number 4. When you hit equal, it finds the median of this set of data. Again, you can't find mode using this calculator, so you just need to find the mode by looking at your data.